fun.
Oh yeah, it's nothing.
Thank you.
Nicole Podota on the national anthem here from the Bradford West Golden Berry Arena. And oh, it has been a long, long summer for the defending champs, but we are finally back for some home Bradford Rattler action. They are wearing their home whites. They welcome the first round matchup of this year, or last year's playoff rather, the West Nipissing Lynx. The Bradford Rattlers, time to defend what is theirs. The Russell Cup Championship, their fourth in history. Starting goaltenders for tonight's contest for the West Nipissing Lynx, it's a newcomer. Number one, Vladislav Morozichuk, native of Russia, last year playing for the North York Renegades of the GMHL. He started in six contests, he won three of them. The reigning goaltender of the year for the Greater Metro Junior Hockey League from Budapest, Hungary, reigning champion, number one, Oliver Balázs. And last season, Balázs, 21 wins, 2 losses, made 654 saves, had a goals against average of 2.24 and a save percentage of 0.932. Unbelievable as Baum got in with a quick chance and the puck is dropped and away we go. Blake Anderson from the blue line, his high shot couldn't get a deflection as it went by the netminder Morozichuk, and back into the corner where it's flagged back down, and Ambrose takes it out and through center. And he picked off by Kuchma. Kuchma pass picked off by Liam Thor. He's a returning player for these West Nipissing Lynx. An outlet pass, and here come the Bradford Rattlers. You're looking at number 19, Blake Barber. His shot into the glove of the netminder Morozichuk, and he holds on. Sorry, that was Blake Anderson getting that shot as head coach David Mooney, returning Russell Cup champion head coach David Mooney, sending out his second line and taking in this faceoff is Melker Merlander, the 19-year-old from Sweden, who currently sits at 6 foot tall exactly. From the tie to the blue line, it's Shamil Lutfulin. We'll get into the corner now where Frank Ekholm, and a tie up there, and it gets squirted loose. Puck rimmed around from the far side, and getting to it first there is Jacob Bundy wearing number 12 in white. Pinned up against the board by D'Anthony Bendel to the corner now. Spinning away is Mirko Merlander. Merlander pinned up, and it gets to the play of Barber. Takes a look and makes an out pass. Picked off there by Bundy again. Bundy bringing it into the zone, and it's picked off there by Laurent. Played the bank right to the play of Jacob Bundy. His neutral zone pass got over for Weisshe. Couldn't pick it up there, and so Bundy just trying to relay it out of the zone, and the puck stays into the neutral zone as you see Lutfulin make a step up there, and getting sent to the ice there was Aaron Stemper on a physical check there by Weisshe. Matthias Weisshe, in 3 games played this year, has 9 points, 5 goals, and 4 assists. He was their leading scorer for West Nipissing. This is their 4th game played of the season. The Rattlers the first. High stick there made by Anders Bunzenix. His shot got the glass. Coming away back is Stemper. He avoided a check from another 14, Dean Cicerone. Cicerone, his pass getting tripped up there by Cicerone. And that's going to be a call on the West Nipissing Lynx. And so the Bradford Rattlers will get their first power play opportunity of this season. Pair of 14s going on it. Again, that was Aaron Stemper, native of Melun, France, a 16-year-old, standing at 5'8". Bradford Rattlers get a power play here. Last year, their power play was at 23%. They had 52 power play goals all year long, and it continued into the playoffs. One of the big reasons why these Rattlers won the Russell Cup. The blue line now, Kuchma. Picks it up there from the line. Kuchma back down low. Strand in front there, and a great glove grab out of the air was made by Vladislav Morozichuk. Off the tie-up, still 1:40 to go. That puck came loose right in front of the net. Rebound, they back away, they score! Alvin Malm on the power play. Gets the Rattlers off and running. Alfred Baum getting the first goal of this season for the Bradford Rattlers. Blake Anderson getting the only assist on the power play goal. So the first power play opportunity of this season was a successful one. Now the Lynx are back into the zone to look for more and look for an answer goal. It's on the stick of Blake Barber. His backhand feed got it across and relayed in front just out of reach of McLaughlin. And so taking it along now is Richard Kuchma. Long stretch pass trying to elevate it across to Bernay. Just out of his reach, and so the Lynx are called on an icing with 16:54 to go in this first period of play. Sorry about that brief in the action there. Some guys in front of me sitting late in the direction. They're standing up. I couldn't see. Couldn't see the play, and we were just doing some last-minute edits to the live stream here. As you could probably notice that there was no score on the clock for the West Edmonton Lynx, so we just went ahead and fixed all that. Never said it was a smooth operation to got here streaming the games, but it does work, and so we leave it at that. It works, so we're good. Lining to the faceoff, Alexander Dubuk for the Lynx, unable to pull it back into the corner, and so playing the bank is Jacob Bundy, just as far as center before it was touched up with a high stick, and so play is called at 15:37 to go in this first period. Alvin Baum getting the first goal of tonight's contest, and in my opinion, yet the loudest reaction when he was announced there by PA announcer JR. Actually, I am quite sure he was the loudest reaction, as the very last four players announced here for the Bradford Rattlers roster this year were the four returning players from the cup-winning team last year. Again, those players are Alvin Baum, Oliver Balage, Pavel Rotskov, and Tyler Baxter, who is not playing here tonight. Expect them to be back next Sunday when the Rattlers take on the Knights of Meaford. Lynx just trying to get possession of the puck, and they have it here. Their leading scorer, Matthias Whiteshay. Whiteshay trying to lay it back, and he's trying to regain the puck and tries to whirl it towards goal before it was blocked by Aaron Stemper. Nice backhand pass on the through seam. It was made by Zachary Major. Throw pass was broken up, and so Artem Borisov comes in. He'll get a snapshot on goal before it's blocked away by the shin pad of Matthias Strolet. Aerial pump away. Found Gage Navziger. Navziger into the corner. Puck battling away from Chivaroni. So comes to the half boards where a long stretch pass can be made to Anderson. Blake Anderson. His shot stopped by the netminder. Big rebound. It's loose and cleared away. And a long stretch pass out of the reach of the intended puck handler there, Nathan Fisher. And so the Lynx have been called on yet another icing. That is their third here in this period. And we are just past the 5-minute mark of this first. 14:28 to go. Square number one. Vladislav Morozov again in goal for the West Edmonton Lynx. We were expecting Carson Lockhart to be in goal, as he had most of the workload so far this season and also last year as well. We have a penalty on the board. It's against the Bradford Rattlers, and so the Lynx get their first opportunity on the power play. Last year, it was only 15% for the West Nipissing Lynx. Not ideal, as you want to be just right into the 18 to 20% for your special teams and power play. Same goes to the penalty killers. You take away 18%, and that's a pretty good penalty kill. If you can average that around 82%, that's a pretty good penalty kill. As far as the GMHL is concerned, Thomas Greifstrand can lift that puck down the length of the ice, but the first one to get it is Blake Keller, shorthanded. Getting worked over by Blake Barber into the corner. Puck came skittered loose to Zachary Major. Sevenen Black to make a deep pass to Laurent. Laurent, Levin and Black weaving his way around Blake Keller and gets it into the zone. He's met there by Lookfoot. Elias leads it over to his other teammate there, Rotzkoff, to the blue line, Laurent. Pass was intercepted, and so Lookfoot, number 55 in the white, can send that puck down the length of the ice. As the netminder for the Lynx can elevator a pass back to Zachary Major. Blade to the boards to Filion, 21 in Black. Skates his way in, leads it to the corner where Liam Thor is after it. Thor got it to the front there and guided it through, and Pavel Rotzkoff had to be sharp on that defensive read to smack it away into the half boards. Fisher back behind the cage, sharp angle bid there, never got on goal to Balage. Drolle back into the corner now. Fisher can wrap it around, getting it to it first is 25 Melker Melander, and he can get that puck down the length of the ice with 20 seconds to go on this Lynx power play. Matthias Drolle end up there by Frank Ekholm. Lynx still with possession, 10 seconds remaining in the penalty. Nathan Fisher got stood up there by number 5 in white, Marcus Vargas. Native of Sweden, the 20-year-old there. Filion loose in front. Savinia got a chance there. And the penalty has expired. We're back to 5-on-5. Shot coming out of the zone, and now a foot race. Horosiuk gave it away. A chance here for Anderson. Trying to work it back in front. The netminder was down. It just couldn't quite connect. And a breakaway pass there. Look out, just out of the reach of Filion, who was grabbing his face and may have been getting a high stick back behind the play. Action starting to pick up here now. You figure the Lynx would have more pace in this game in the early games, more speed and controlling the play early, but so far it's been all the Bradford Rattlers since the Lynx have played 3 games in the season, with this being the Rattlers' first game. Perhaps some rust and just getting used to new teammates. I'm sure a lot of people in here remember their first game on a brand new team or same team, different year. It's a big step up there. Aiden Miller put his man to the ground, and that got the bench going for the Bradford Rattlers. One way to make a good first impression on your teammates, deliver a big hit like that. I tell you, they'll love you. Back into the corner, it's Lutfalin's play. His pass skittered on through 2 players in between Aiden Miller and Merritt Nukamanoff. Very young Bradford Rattler team here this season. Years before, the Rattlers always averaged towards one of the more older teams in the GMHL as Bernay just leveled Pavel Rotzkoff back behind the net. Rotzkoff seems to be all right. He's back into the play looking over the high slot area. And the puck comes over to his play where he will now make a play. Gerle crunches him again. That's 2 times in one shift that Pavel Rotzkoff has been introduced to Bernay. Marc-Olivier Ambroise. Pass fluttered on through. Now Rotzkoff fanning on the pass. Aaron Stemper through the middle. Taken away by Cicerone, and he can pitch it back into the corner and relay it on back for Balazs and leave it for Rotzkoff. Goes against the flow to the play of Artem Borisov. Borisov, stretch pass there, it's Andrei Bunzanik's got through, Bunzanik's a shot, stopped by Vladislav Morajza. off to the left of the netminder, Morziuk. Nick Anderson went down on that play into the Lynx. Half possession, Bolin. Long stretch pass to Chitteroni, trying to get by Marcus Vargas, couldn't do so. The forward offering some defensive help was Blake Anderson, lost the puck however. Turnaround bid there by Fisher, whipping it towards the goal, and a good reverse hit on Chitteroni. Puck still loose for grabs. Taken away by the Rattlers, a flutter punch out of the zone, but it doesn't come loose. The defenseman Major pinching in, Chitteroni just trying to lay it in deep, and so does Link. Trying to get a cycle going, but the Rattlers are quick after the puck handler, not allowing the Lynx to get any room in the offensive zone whatsoever. Nice breakout here, it's Blake Keller. His shot, he scores! Blake Keller! 2-0 Rattlers! Blake Keller, saw him in the prospect games here in Bradford. I tell you, I knew he'd be something good as soon as the Rattlers made that signing and made the official announcement on their social medias of Blake Keller coming along, the native of St. Cloud, Minnesota, the 21-year-old. I mentioned how the Rattlers are a younger team here this year compared to most seasons. Blake Keller comes in as a 21-year-old standing at 6'2". He used his side speed and strength to get by the two Lynx defenders and blow it right by the glove, posting in from the netminder, Vladislav Morasiuk. Oliver Malm picks up his second point of tonight's contest. He got the primary assist. Big hit in front! Richard Kuchma just laid out his man right in front of the Rattler bench. Blake Barber to the blue line. Lynx with possession, however. Balazs read that all the way through and directed it into the corner to the blue line. It's kept alive by D'Anthony Bendel, forward on defense here this game. He did play defense in the last contest against the Omeguin Spartans. Melander back in front on the backhand bid. Stop, rebound. Morozyuk looked behind him and made the save and found the puck. He will hold on for a stop and play with 8 minutes and 21 seconds to go in this first period. Quite the showing by the Rattlers and quite the showing by returning player Aldrin Malm. 2 points already. Oliver Balazs back behind the play noticed something on the ice surface. Referee picks it up and he will dispatch up. Most likely hockey tape as it's black in color, so you imagine it's a mouth guard or probably a piece of tape. Very common for hockey players to lose some tape on their sticks. Shocker, I know. Jason Bob Salt, the Quebec native, trying to steer that puck out of the zone, couldn't do so, and so Liam Thor will try it now. Defenseman Pavel Rodzgov gaining it offensively there. He peels on back, switches places with forward Aiden Miller. Miller from Aurora, Ontario, 16 years of old, 6'3" at 16. Lutfuller takes his man there, and Savignac destroys his man along the corner boards. That was Benjamin Deririum on the receiving end of that Savignac hit, 34 in black. Deririum back after it, however, he'll punch it further deep into the corner to the opposite wing, where delay is met by a check by 24 in white, Aiden Miller. That shot skittered on goal, deflected away with the paddle with a purpose by the netminder, Vladislav Morozyuk. Williams going off on a line change. You can see that puck coming to him. Got to be careful on those plays there. You can get pulled very easily. No, too many men on the ice call. Long stretch pass didn't work. However, it just might. Skating on up to it, and a shot there turned away by the netminder. That was Artem Borisov with a great chance on goal for the Bradford Rattlers, and it remains a 2-0 lead for Team White. A connection pass there by Bunzeniks, but the Rattlers are called offside. Former captain of the Bradford Rattlers, Julian McCarthy, just walking by us here at the announcer's booth here at center. Nice little interaction there with Julian McCarthy, son of former NHLer Sandy McCarthy. He views McCarthy on defense here as the Lynx have a nice chance on goal against Palage, and he makes the save and gets bowled over in the process. Wes Bippensink is trying to throw anything they can up the defending goaltender of the year. And if he makes the save, hey, crash the net, try to get him off this game. 6 minutes and 33 seconds to go in this first period. Again, great to see Julian McCarthy, big piece of the leadership core that made the Rattlers go all the way to the Russell Cup Championship. And a pretty good feeling for McCarthy, I might add, being the first one to go over to President Bob Russell and receive the trophy first. Always a dream of any captain in any league sport. Always being that first one to collect the trophy. And then spreading the wealth amongst the teammates. Can't be hogging the trophy all the time. Bradford Rattlers have a power play, or a penalty here rather. The Lynx on the power play as Thor got a shot away and Balazs had to be square on that one as Savinjak pulled into his man and the puck got flinged down the length of the ice by number 8 in white. Richard Kuchma, who's delivered a few decent hits here in this first period. In last season, Bradford Rattlers penalty kill 87%. Yeah, that's pretty good. That's a pretty good penalty kill. Rattlers are already 1-0 on the PK here tonight. Netminder for Lynx getting off his cage to play it. Relay it along. Blake Anderson was about offside for a solid 40 seconds. Lynx had about maybe two chances at a glorious goal scoring opportunity. And those gonna hurt their chances even more to generate anything as Filion will head into the penalty box. And he talked back to the ref and he's got another 2 minutes added onto that. Filion sitting in for 2 minutes. So in 47 seconds time, the Bradford Rattlers will have himself a second power play opportunity. So we got some 4-on-4 action here tonight. Belker Melander, native of Sweden, lines him on the face-off against Alexander DeBuck. DeBuck's able to pull back for his respective team in black and yellow. Carson Lalonde got a pass over for Barber. Barber bumped away by Lutfalin, and so it gets now to Carson Lalonde. Steered off by Roadscomb. Frank Ekholm got it back to Lutfalin, and he gets a return pass for Ekholm. Ekholm, he's a big guy, 20 years old, 6'4", look at him go. Ekholm trying to steer it back into the front of the cage, and crashing into the netminder was Melker Melander. Ekholm trying to connect on his countrymen there, both players from Sweden. And it's quite the theme. If you've been watching some of the Bradford Rattlers games throughout the years, you'll notice a lot of Russians and a lot of Swedes. And hey, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. They're defending champions for a reason. We wait this neutral zone faceoff, taking the faceoff for West Dickinson, number 22, Alexander DeBuck. Number 16, Alvin Malm, with 2 points here tonight, will take the faceoff, native of Finnsburg, Sweden. That Swedish connection the Rattlers have going on. Look at the puck angling there by Blake Keller. Able to give it through to Alvin Malm. Won't pull the trigger, trying to feed it back into the front there before it's gloved off. Rattlers now on the power play. Power play reads 3 minutes and 7 seconds remaining. And more time will be killed off as the Lynx elevator that puck down the length of the ice. And the first touch up to be made by Richard Kuchma. Soft pass on a connect. Blake Anderson just overskated it. And so DeBuck makes a nice pivot move going against the flow and getting that puck back to Oliver Blas behind his net. Miscommunication there. No one on the Rattlers team wanted it. To be expected. It's the first game of the season. No need for panic. look like Richard Kuchma agrees. He even signals to his team, settle it down, settle it down. We're okay here. And it looks like it's going to work as they get a very clean and proper break in. Umbrios pinned up against the boards, battling away with his stick in front of Thomas Graves-Strand. Off the short glass and nod out and just keeping the puck alive. It's Richard Kuchma. Passing to the corner board. Strand lost it for Thor. His turnaround shot was blocked. And then wheeling that puck back down the length of the ice. DeBook checking his face as he blocked that clearing attempt right in the mouth. Getting some speed is Blake Anderson. Trying to beat his man wide. Anderson on the forehand. Takes a look around. Back into the slot. Ciceroni battling away before it's eventually swallowed up. Marozia has been the busier goaltender of the two here in tonight's contest. Again, we weren't expecting him to be in tonight. As checking the rosters last night on the GMHL website, he was not listed on the team, and so this is a very new acquisition. The first time we saw him, or knew he was on the team, was when we saw him come out for warm-ups, leading the team out for warm-ups. So if the goaltender's leading you out, that goaltender is most likely starting the contest. That's how it goes in the NHL. I don't know, it could be different here as we see another shot and score! Artem Borisov makes it 3-0 Rattlers. It's another power play goal. It's going to be very interesting to see how the Bradford Rattlers react to this 3-goal lead. See how well defensively they play as they've got all their offense out of the gate and early. They got it good so far. Let's see how good defensively they are. So Bradford Rattlers have been known as a very stellar team. And you know, it's last year, I don't know if you remember, he said the starts have not favored the Bradford Rattlers. It was towards the later part, like the halfway mark of last year's season. Yeah, sure, they did win the Russell Cup, but hey, in the last half of the season, the starts, especially here at home, a little something to worry about, but the worries quickly went away as the Rattlers, about halfway into each game, stormed back and scored out on average 5 goals in a period. They'll blow it up in the second, third period, kind of take a little backseat to play some various. I mean that offensively. Their offensive game, however, picks up significantly in the last frame of regulation time, and let's see if this will carry over into this season. A giveaway there. Back into the zone is Bundy. Bundy on a drop pass. Coming back in is Yagi. His shot testing the netminder there. For West Nipissing. Battleslav. Morozia. Makes a stop on the Bradford Rattlers there. Everyone is learning every other teammate. And that's exactly what we're doing here in the broadcast week. So if you don't get a player's number exactly right away, that is why. It takes a little bit to start remembering the players' names fully. The more times we see the links, the more times we see the Rattlers, the more the players' names are going to be going into their heads, so it'll be easier to call the game to get better information towards you guys watching the game here tonight. But I've seen some of the comments correcting me on who's in playing here tonight and who's not. If I mess up a name or a number or anything like that, please call it out and I will correct that mistake to the best of my abilities. No promises, you know, I can miss a few things here and there, but definitely try to get it right for people watching at home, because it's you people that make this stream possible. And so again, thank you here from Nick Stella and the Bradford Rattlers organization. This home opener here on this Sunday night on ice from the BWG. Rattler fans like what they see here early. 3-0 in the first period with 1 minute and 15 seconds to go in this first frame of regulation. Blake Keller, a lead pass over for number 19, Blake Anderson. He got it across there before it's picked up now. Marc Olivier and Broyce got it back in and it gets on goal to Balazs. Neil Palmley glove that puck up and gives his defenders a tap on the shin pads there, saying, hey, good box out, good defensive play. 58 seconds now in this first period. Head coach David Mooney must love what he's seen from his boys here early. Again, no Tyler Baxter, a returning player from last year's cup-winning team, not in the lineup here tonight. Again, expect him to be back next Sunday when the Knights and Leafers go into town for the first time. Blake Keller, native of St. Cloud, Minnesota. A nice curl and drag move, trying to work it back to the front area. The defensive read is made by William Ombrios to the blue line. A flutter shot looking for a redirection there was number 8, Richard Kuchma. Back into the zone, Oliver Blodge. Out of his cage to play it, a bank. Over to Thomas Greifstrand. Melker Melander lost an edge, but still gained possession of the puck and still was able to make a play. Melander a feed to Keller, a nice touch pass just out of the reach of Blake Anderson. And so Liam Thor got it on back, but it's picked off there by Keller again, who's been up there for quite a bit. Doesn't matter because the period has come to a close. After 20 minutes of play, the Bradford Rattlers lead by 3-0 over in Malm with 2 points in the opening frame. Oliver Blodge with a perfect period. We'll be back for the second period of play after this quick break. second period set underway here from the BWG. The Bradford Rattlers holding a 3-0 lead over the West Nipissing Lynx. And again, starting goaltenders for Grant's contest. Number one for the Rattlers, defending goaltender of the year, Oliver Balazs. And for the West Nipissing Lynx, number one, Vladislav Morajczyk. Skipping up the wing with some speed is Blake Anderson, testing Morajczyk there. And he's able to make the bread basket save off of Blake Anderson, number 19, and white native of Peavine, Alberta. One of the older players on the team, Blake Anderson, he is 21 years old, sitting at 5'10". You see him lining up into the faceoff circle. Linesman just checking on one defenseman for the Lynx back behind the play. That'd be William Umbrias. Quick shot off the faceoff there, off the trigger pull there. Blake Keller, the St. Cloud, Minnesota native, got that quick hot shot into the glove, however, to be snared away by Morajczyk. Defensive change on for the Lynx. Barber and Bendal will guard the D. Bendal, native of Toronto, with the 19-year-old. At the blue line, shot there from the line by Kuchma. Loves to hit, and he loves to get that puck on the goal. Number 8 in white, as you see that puck get to him there for his play. Backhand attempt on the first try was spammed on before Keller can lay it on back over for Strand. Strand to pass, found Anderson. Anderson through the middle, nice touch pass there by Malm. Broken up there by Blake Barber, a backhand swing around effort. Just trying to pitchfork that puck out of the zone, so Liam Thor will tie it up against the corner boards, or the half boards, I should say. Still tied up into the feet of Strand. Getting that puck and prying it loose was Malm, trying to make one too many moves around Savignac, and he made the nice defensive play as a forward. Liam Thor starts out, number 72 in black, trying to get by Kuchma, centering pass, Savannah. His shot, Balazs never had to make a move on it. Long stretch feed just out of the reach of Blake Anderson, and so the Rattlers are called on their second icing call of Lance contest. Kuchma and Anderson had a little discussion skating back to the faceoff zone about where that play should have been, how that pass should have been taken. Offensive zone faceoff won cleanly by the Lynx, shot by Doyle from the blue line, or rather Drouet. A long knock puck comes to Frank Uphome, an elevator pass over for Anderson. Using his speed here, Blake Anderson tried to cut through two defensemen in black and gold. Was not working there, didn't have a number advantage. He's a skilled player. A little tough order to skate through that many players. The late penalty coming up, it's going to go against the Bradford Rattlers as they've touched the puck up about three times and still no whistle. And they finally touch up there. They had to get possession of it. That is by mistake. Forgot the rule for a quick moment. You can shield it down and flag the puck down. You've got to have control of that puck. Get that whistle call. Justin, the Rattlers did not want to touch it up as they are now shorthanded. No one in the box just yet. It looks like it's going to be Blake Anderson's penalty. Kind of signaled a little dive action as he turned back and looked at the Rattler bench. Third power play. Opportunity for the West of the Singlings. Oliver Balazs just checking out with his paraphernalia right now, getting some help from one of the officials here tonight in Bradford. Alexandre Dubuc on the faceoff of the Lynx. A nice pullback there by the Rattlers. Melker Millander. Lutfullin battled his man against the corner boards. The puck escaped through from Thor. Rodskov, a returning player for the Rattlers, will send that puck down the length of the ice to kill more time off the penalty. Major, a stretch pass, trying to connect on his man, off number 6, Blake Barber, but from the wrong side of center, and so an icing has been called on the team donning black and gold. West Nipissing in history, throughout the years, haven't had that much success over the Bradford Rattlers, especially here at the BWG. Bradford seems to pull through all those games, and these two teams have been meeting in the playoffs. One where Rattlers quite easily dispatched of the West Nipissing Lynx, so it was a tough series. The scoreboard might say a different story. If you were watching the game, which I sure you were, you would understand. Pavel Rodzkov shorthanded, killing as much time as he can, and so he will throw it on goal to Mrazza. And the Lynx still looking a little bit sloppy here on this power play. A big run and effort there by Frank Ekholm, burying his man. Scary sight when you see a 6'4" forward coming barreling at you in full speed. That's exactly what the man saw as Ekholm was right on him and delivered the boom. Weisce, the Lynx leading scorer, trying to test Balazs, but a good defensive read was made by Marcus Vargas, not allowing the Lynx leading scorer to get any opportunity on goal. Major returns around for Carson Lalonde, number 11 in black. Nice connection to Major, got stood up there, but the puck went into the zone. And it comes back, however, as Filion peels on back as far as center and relays back in and pitchforks a pass back into the opposite corner where it's shrugged back along from the rattled around the play to Savignac. Savignac back to Filion, back behind the goal. Penalty set to expire. Anderson is out in three. Rolling a shot, he scores! Carson Lalonde. Sturgeon Falls, Ontario native. A power play goal for the Lynx. It's 3-1. Three power play goals scored in tonight's contest. One by the Lynx, two by the Rattlers. The official score clock reads 4-0 Rattlers. And they are now just changing. In the center zone tie-up, it's the Lynx with possession again. And in the first period, when the Rattlers were up 3-0 in the later goings of the first period of regulation, I said it'd be interesting to see how the Rattlers defend. I mean, they got all the offense they need in the first period. You know, they get the three goals. They seem to be all right. This is the one thing that you were worrying of for the Bradford Rattlers. You know, a new team, only three returning players on the ice right now. How would they mesh together? How will they defend from a little bit of adversity, as the Lynx do get that answering goal to make it 3-1, only down by two. Let's see how the Rattlers now react even more urgency on them. They've given up one. How do they answer? In years past, they've answered pretty well, normally getting the victory as they finish first place overall in the regular season, and score all the way to win the Russell Cup Championship. Sharp angle bid there by Brunet, and it was steered away by deflection by Aaron Stemper, the Malouin, France native. A lot of Europeans on this Bradford Rattler roster, but is that a shocker? Correct answer is no. No, it's not a shocker. And Ryu's off the faceoff on a trigger pull from the range. Got the glass on the shot, and a good pickup there by Aiden Miller. He'll test the netminder of Zarek. And he'll hold on for a faceoff with 15:16 to go in this second period. Isaac will now await the faceoff coming to the left of him. Offensive draw for the Bradford Rattlers. Don Jerome Gagge will line up on the faceoff, native of Zurich, Switzerland. Good faceoff win there. A shot was blocked on the first attempt there, just trying to get that puck, but played on a hand pass by Durlay. An injured player for the Bradford Rattlers, that is Lutfelin. Bunch of sticks were swinging down low in the area, as Lutfelin was going down, I believe he may have caught one pot. No call on the play, so it must have been from his own man. Nonetheless, the Rattlers get some fresh lines out onto the ice right now for this another offensive zone faceoff. Jaggy again pulls it. Savignac couldn't clear the zone. A good pincher effort was made by Vargas. Vargas able to keep the zone. He played it long for Aiden Miller's corner. Savignac, first after, he made a good spun around attempt there, and skating is Caleb Boylan, trying to skitter it past through Hellenius. Unable to connect there. That's a big hit at center. Nathan Fisher cleaned his man out back behind the play. Puck stays in the link zone, however. Back into the corner boards. Merritt Nugamanov after it until Chitteroni trying to get that puck down the length of the ice, and they'll do so here. Icing called on West Nipissing. They've had a tire bunch out there for a while now, and they're going to be hemmed in their own zone some more off that icing call with 14:30 to go here in the second period. Oliver Malmquist has 2 points here tonight. Unable to win that faceoff, just skating away with Steve Anthony Vendel, number 19 in black. Rattler's possession, looking it to the blue line. It's Strand shot from the line, and it got deflected and went wide. Blake Keller kind of grimacing over on the far side of the ice. That puck comes towards him right off the stanchion and drops right in front of Strand to the blue line now. A long shot getting the glass on the trigger pull by Anderson, who kind of hurried his shot even though he had some time and space. Never a bad idea to get the puck on the net. Rattler's back in for more. A shot there by Hellenius went wide. Or pardon me, that was Blake Keller. He's going after the puck handler there. Keller trying to stymie his way around, but Blake Barber's able to send it back looking for Liam Thor. But another icing call on the Lynx with 13:39 to go in this first period. One player I want to bring up is number 91 for the Rattlers, Hugo Kosh, who's not in the lineup here tonight. We got talking to some of the guys from the Rattlers. Apparently, he's one of the best forwards, probably the best player, is what I've been hearing. Very intrigued to see Hugo Kosh play for the Bradford Rattlers. And again, one of those players where you expect to see them next Sunday when they take on the Knights of Meaford. And the roster you saw in the introduction of tonight's contest and what you see during the intermission slideshow, we'll call it, those rostered players are scheduled to change, of course. The team lineup is set for tonight. Head coach David Mooney definitely has a plan of what he wants going forward for this team. But don't expect this exact same group of players to be the same group of players that ends up finishing this regular season, as there's a lot of some chances for other returning players to come back, trades, signings, more acquisitions. Players that currently aren't playing right now as a healthy scratch could step into a bigger role. A lot of things can change here in the season, but one constant we can probably bet on is netminder number one, Oliver Lodge, being the number one netminder throughout the entire year and into the playoffs. But we're talking playoffs, and it's the home opener, first game of the year. We're getting a little ahead of ourselves. But definitely the expectation for the Bradford Rattlers. Playoffs making it is good, but going all the way and going deep is the main priority of this successful GMHL franchise. Puck is still in the link zone. It's Bunzanich trying to make a centering play. He is a former South Muskoka Shield, signed here in the offseason for Bradford. Aaron Stemper through the corner. Picking up now was Bunzadix. His pass was intercepted, and so Liam Thor and Marcus Vargas in a foot race. Thor, a sharp angle bid, trying to catch Balazs napping. That puck skittered on wide, right and through of the crease area. Aaron Stemper on a return pass. Hellenius gives in. Aaron Stemper prowling along from over his man. And so the puck gets steered back into the half boards and then up the gut to Doyle. Doyle to try and settle that rolling puck down. Strand was there to cover him defensively. Long stretch pass just out of the reach of Don Jerome Jaggy. He would have been all alone on a breakaway. A great opportunity for the Bradford Rattlers to regain their 3-goal lead that they had in the first period and in the early goings of the second period. Carson Lalonde opened the scoring for the Lynx there as Weishay got a shot on goal to Oliver Balazs. Easy routine save for the netminder of the year. We mentioned it in the opening. We were surprised that Carson Lockhart Number 34 of the West Pacific Lynx was not the starting goalie here tonight as Balazs has to make that alert save on the blocker hand. He was screened all the way, never saw that shot coming from William Ambrios. Nonetheless, it's Vladislav Moraisa in goal, making his West Pacific Lynx debut here this season. Puck picked up from the line. Zachary Major looking for Weiss J in front there. Just couldn't quite connect. The most leading scorer on the team, all alone in front of Balazs, is picking that puck up with Aiden Miller. But a good read by the linesman. That was called offside. Quite the rare sight. I'm giving the officials and the linesman their props. That's not supposed to happen. Approaching the halfway mark of this contest and also this period. 10 minutes and 48 to go in period number two. We have a good one here tonight. It's been a tight one here in period number two. Only one goal has been scored thus far, and now it's a power play goal by Carson Lalonde of the West of the St. Lynx, and the Lynx are trying to get more. Unable to pick up that puck now, and that allows the Rattlers to skate on a 3-on-2. A drop pass. Anderson looking for Keller, who found him. Keller behind the cage, trying to set up shot. Keller, cross ice seam to the blue line. A shot by Rodskov was denied there by Moraisa. Clearing attempt not out to the blue line. Lutfulin trying to pass it on through to Anderson. Just couldn't quite reach up in time. That was Kilton McLaughlin. Pardon me, that was not Kilton McLaughlin. Number 77 for the West of the St. Lynx. We don't actually have him on our player card right here. Whenever we can, we'll try to get that player identified properly for you guys. That does happen sometimes. I apologize for a little break in the action there. I didn't talk to one of the guys working here for the Bradford Rattlers. The West Pacific Lynx have come back and made this a one-goal game off the stick of D'Anthony Bendel. Like I mentioned earlier, how are the Rattlers going to react being up 3-0? A lot of people say 3-0 is the worst lead in hockey. I kind of like to disagree with that, because I mean, any lead is a good lead in my opinion, but for some reason it's those three goals. Perhaps the team, a brand new team here at the Rattlers, getting used to the systems, they're getting a little loosey-goosey, as Don Cherry would say. A little loosey-goosey here to try. The Lakes right now are getting a little tight right now. They're tightening up offensively. They're really locking down the center slot zone in front of their netminder, Vladislav Moraisa. Really just shutting down the high speed of the Bradford Rattlers. And if you're Bradford, you got to get that next goal. The most important part of the game is going to be what happens next. Get that first goal, and the next team to get the next goal are going to have a lot of momentum going into the later goings of the second period, and most likely into the later goings of the third. So getting the next goal is going to be huge for either team here as we hit 8:40 to go in this second period. Jacob Bundy, Oshaga, Ontario native, made the long pass across to Aaron Stemper. Stemper, a native of France, getting met into the corner there with the check. Picking it up now was Borisov. His shot whipped on wide to the blue line, kept alive by Strand, however. Shot blocked into the paraphernalia of Dorlay. Stands into the zone, a good pivot around move by Strand. Cossine pass, shooting that one. Oh, and what a stop made by Moraisa. Came across and denied Borisov. Borisov may have took a little too much time dusting off that puck before getting a shot away. To the blue line there, Strand will go D-to-D to his man Kuchma. His shot blocked again. Chitteroni had that pass go off him, not out of the zone. Puck into the corner boards now, coming back behind the netminder. Jolet picks it up off the boards, and Chitteroni just sweeping out that puck, finally gets it on and out of the zone. As far as center, however, Rattlers trying to stymie their way back in. Aaron Stemper racing after his man. Rattlers are offside, however. Took a while for Aiden Miller to realize that, or pardon me, that was Borisov unless the faceoff is going to come right to the middle of the ice surface. Or pardon me, the official was there, so I assume it's going in the middle. It's coming all the way back into the Rattlers' zone, as the Rattlers had all sorts of time to clear the zone. They never did. Whistle sounds, faceoff all the way back into the Bradford Rattlers' territory. Savignac on the draw for the Lynx, unable to pull it back on a good win by Don Jerome Jagi. Puck fluttered in through center, right into the opposite corner where Rhodeskov will meet it back behind the net. Opposite peel back. A pitchfork attempt there to his returning player, Nugamanov. Rhodeskov, the three-year Rattler veteran, laid it into the corner. There, shot off the cage of Morisuk to the blue line. Look for Lynx, snapped his stick in half. There goes $300. Unable to make a play with Lutzlin without a stick, and so he'll just get off on a line change. On comes Petteri Helenius, who makes a play. Not the best of plays he could have made in that situation, but he was under a lot of pressure, and nonetheless put possession back to the team in white and green. Zachary Major, 7 in black. Long stretch pass, found his man Filion, but it just rolled over the top of his stick. Lodge, the very active netminder, out of his cage to play it, picked off by Liam Thor on the backhand, leading it for Savignac. To the blue line now, nice move there by Jolet coming in, his shot stopped by Balazs. Big rebound, it gets kicked to the corner there. Zachary Major taking it back along there for Rhodeskov. Rhodeskov laid it along with Savignac, laid it to play. Big check in front there, as down on the ice is Filion, and he is feeling all of that contact there by Petteri Helenius. And he is slow to get up, but he is able to get up under his own strength, and that is always good to see. We love a good hit, but we love it even more if the player does get up right away. A little gingerly heading back to the Lynx bench now. He's going to get looked at by one of the trainers. Normally the head trainer for the Lynx has been Austin Taylor, buddy of mine who I've known for minor hockey, you know, his dad coached our team, he was the major Bantam Innisfil Winterhawks. Oh yeah, back in the day, 6 or 7 years ago, not that long ago, but definitely been some time. Wishing Austin Taylor from the Lynx the best of luck here in this season, as a missed call there. Puck stays into the zone for the Lynx there. Weishay was heading towards the net, couldn't get a play there. Then picked off there by Blake Anderson, trying to split the D, but coming on back defensively. His number 11, Carson Lalonde, native of Sturgeon Falls, Ontario. 18 years old, standing at 6 feet tall, exactly. Blake Anderson trying to make a play back behind the cage, and see what I mean about the Lynx defenders. They are getting very aggressive and physical, as you see Anderson relay a deflection, trying to go in between the trees of Moriza. That's a good answer there on those redirections. Best thing to do is just get as low as you can quickly. Both deflections go from high to low. It's rare, especially here in junior hockey, in the GMHL, it's rare to see a deflection go low to high. It's normally high to low. So far in this contest, deflection-wise, Morisuk for the Lynx has been rather perfect. I believe there's been 3 deflection shots in tonight's contest. One by the man with 2 points here tonight, Oliver Mahl. Morisuk doing a great job taking the lower part of the net. This team with possession, it's the leading point getter, Weishay. Lynx unable to get possession of the puck in the Bradford Rattlers zone for a little moment here. Weishay trying to return it back to the buck. He just avoids a hit there, trying to stymie away from Richard Kochma. Pass up the middle, just bobbled over a bunch of sticks from the Lynx. That's a rolling puck right now, very hard to settle and make a play on. Strand picks it up for the Rattlers, who makes the easy play to Ekholm. Ekholm, a nice elevator pass, he connects onto his man. Getting in front there, and a rising shot coming off the stick by Kuchma. It goes up and out of play. I'm not too sure if Morisuk got a piece of that one. Kuchma and Barber having words for each other as they met up into the corner, and the official is getting right in the middle of them to try to break up. A bit of trash talking, you would imagine, going on. Well, that's just a part of hockey. Sometimes it's a mental battle. Sometimes you gotta trip the other player, get into his head, throw him off his game. And I know, because I hear the guys from up here. We are not too far away from around their bench. I've heard some pretty good ones throughout the years. Trash talk. And it's always against the Quebec team. Villemarie and Timiskaming, I don't know what it is. The trash talking just ramps up. And hey, I'm all for it. I love it. You got to get a guy in between the glass to really pick up those hot mics to really hear what's going on. But that'd be a lot of censoring we'd have to do. That seems like a pretty tough. Puck went on goal and got hacked out after the play. And Bernier comes in and lays a hit on his man. And now we got a gathering of the Canes here in front. Gotta imagine Wes Nipissing will be the one penalized after all of this. And Bryos is in there. Jolet. Shamir Lutfulin seems to be the only one heading towards the penalty box, so my assumption is completely wrong. I apologize, folks. Looks like the Lynx are going to get the power play here. A little odd as Oliver Blodge did dive out to make that initial swallow up of the puck. Could be a little biased, I don't know, but it did look like he got a pretty good whack in after the whistle sounded once he had possession of the puck. And of course, hey, you touch the goalie after the whistle goes, you're asking for a scrum, and shocker, that's exactly what's happened. It's a 5-minute major. Wow. I didn't hear any announcement of that or anything signaled by the official that for FC number 5. But nonetheless, a perfect opportunity for Wes Nipissing. Pretty much actually to do the entirety of this second period that has 3 minutes and 55 seconds remaining in it. Five minutes for cross-checking is the official announcement. Thank you, JR, for the clarification. JR, PA announcer here for the Bradford Rattlers. My opinion, the best voice in the GMHL, of course, host of the GMHL podcast, inside the GMHL. Aerial lift through center, brought back down, it's getting after it, and coming out of its cage is Mar Isaac to make the nice play and get it out of the zone. That might allow a 3-on-2 momentarily as Alexander Dubuc was hit there. And he skittered on offside. Wasn't called, however, and so Weisshay can just spear fork it back into the Bradford Rattlers zone with 3 minutes to go in the period. 3:45 to go on the power play for Wes Nipissing. They already have one here tonight, looking for two, and this would be the tying move. Turnaround bid for Weisshay off the stick of Laurent. To the blue line, now it's Major. Back down low, trying to find his man Dubuc in front. Couldn't quite connect, but Barber has it, 6 in black. Blake Barber, defenseman going down low to the corner. He'll play back behind the cage for his man Laurent. Laurent back to Barber. To the blue line now. Major fakes the shot. Weisshay takes the shot in front. Stopped by the netminder, Balazs. Time remaining in this second period. A last minute line change as Richard Kuchma heads off, and it gets slapped out by Keller, not out of the zone, however. Then it finally gets skated out by Melker Molander on a 2-on-1 shorthanded with Keller from the backhand, and he just ran out of real estate. Great job defensively coming back by Matthias Jolet. Rattler still in possession shorthanded. Just under 3 minutes to go in the power play. Liam Thor takes it and he pirouettes back. Thor, calm pass up the middle to Savinia. Backhand Sostis to Filion. Filion back to Drolet, trying to return it back to Filion into his corner. Savinia and Rotskov get after it first. Marcus Vargas gets pinned up into the corner boards by the Lynx. 3 Lynx on 1 Rattler on the boards, and the Lynx win the battle. Thor, his shot was blocked by Rotskov into the corner, but it's up and into the protective mesh. Out of play, it's called. If it was deflected off a Bradford Rattler based off the stake inside the Rattler zone, it looks like that is what's happening. Anderson and Fisher line in for their respective clubs to take the faceoff here, an offensive zone faceoff for the Lynx on the power play. 1:42 to go in the period, 2:27 to go in the 5-minute major penalty. The blue line now comes to Gerlay, back to Savignac. His snapshot kicked out with a purpose by Balazs. Good read by the netminder. Filion will get it to the blue line. 34, Savignac back to Gerlay. Relays it back to the return feed of Gerlay. Gerlay got it back to Savignac. Savignac tried to get it back over to 17, and Black couldn't do so. Savignac maybe will try again, but he's hounded there by Anders Bunzanits. Adams just trying to pry that puck free and get out of the zone, but Thor having none of that, he punches it back in deep. Nathan Fisher just trying to relay it back in front of the net, mouth couldn't do so. Savinia, his shot ripped on wide, the puck creams on out of the zone and racing to it first. It's Blake Anderson, the speedy winger, shorthanded Anderson, and he just pumped it wide. Netminder Moore, Isaac just trying to outweigh him. A chance here, shorthanded again, creating all sorts of chaos in front. Was Peavine, Alberta native Blake Anderson, 19 and white. Thor back in for the Lynx. A good breakup there by Strand, and he'll skate it back out. Strand trying to get by his man. That was number 7, Zachary Major. Big defenseman there having none of that. And he can skate it up offensively to get this breakup going with 20 seconds to go in the period. Lynx need to put anything they can on Balazs right now. A nice seam pass to Debuck, but he just couldn't quite settle that rolling puck. That saucer pass before, a little too off the handle. 10 seconds to go as Oliver Malm makes a drop pass. A play across to Ekholm, back for Malm in front, and it just skittered on wide. Long stretch pass broken up by Rotskov, and that will conclude period number 2. West Nipissing came alive in that second period. They are trailing by 1, but they'll have 45 seconds of power play time to work with. Once the third period starts, I will be back to give you guys the third period after this quick intermission. the center zone faceoff all over again. Third period has officially started, but we will get the flow of play going here in just a second. They're not going to go for the center zone faceoff. They're going to take it just a little further towards the Bradford Rattlers end of the ice for the draw, 2-1 shorthanded, nonetheless, by the Bradford Rattlers. Oliver Malm has been one of the more standout players of tonight's contest. I have jotted down players that have noticed me early in this first game of the year. Blake Keller, number 9 for the Rattlers. These are all Rattler players, of course. Oliver Malm, Blake Keller, a defenseman Richard Kuchma, who's had plenty of good looks on goal, and a bunch of hits here tonight. A bunch. That back around turnaround bid there by Laurent was kicked away by Balage. A loose puck, it comes right in front of the crease area. Skating into it is Major, kicked out with a purpose there by Balage. And the puck gets flicked on as far as center before it's relayed across. Power play is now over. Lutfiin back onto the ice. Weisschick back into the zone, steering it towards Balage. A loose puck, he juggled. Balage is down, puck is loose. Laurent got it. Maybe one last whack on goal before Oliver Balage is able to locate that puck and make the stop with a minute gone in this third period. West Nipissing has scored 2 straight unanswered goals in the second period. The Rattlers have scored all 3 of their goals in the first period, and they got one here early in the first 5 minutes. Liam Thor off the faceoff, all alone in front there. A shot by Filia, turned away by Balage, and Savignac may have got a stick up high. Can we mention the first period? How did the Rattlers react after getting scored on? So far, they're not reacting the way Bradford Rattlers normally react. It's been the Lynx lately controlling offensive play in these early goings of the third period as they nearly caught one in between Balage's legs, and they try to do it again. Balage has to be alert after a few defensive mislaps in a row by the Bradford Rattlers. And head coach David Mooney, see enough. All 5 players on the ice are coming off. Still a 1-goal lead for the Bradford Rattlers, thanks to large part by Oliver Malm, who has 2 points here in this home opener, a goal and an assist. Nice move in front, down low by Jason Bob Salt, try to catch one in front of the 5-hole. Bob is able to clear and seal down the bottom part of the net. Worked around for Hellenius to the middle now, it's Trolley. He works it back in. Lodge touches it up again and spears it away to Hellenius. He'll go D-to-D for Marcus Vargas. Long stretch pass, it comes to Bunzanich. Bunzanich flips it in and gives chase. Aaron Stemper after the puck handler there. Bunzanich picks up to the corner, who gets stood up there by Savignac. Filion dumps it in, it's punched away by Balage. Those dump attempts, always expect Oliver Balage to come out of his cage and play that puck. Mike Smith-like in the way he gets out there and plays the puck, also like Ilya Bryzgalov back in the 2010s, in his days as a Phoenix, I'll say Phoenix Coyote, if they weren't Arizona Coyotes at the time. Very active goaltender, Oliver Balage, and even got a few. I remember, I think he, it's a weird stat, I think he led all Bradford Rattler goaltenders in history in assists. I want to say he had 6 or 7 of them, I believe. Don't quote me on that, but I know it was quite a big number for goaltenders. That's approaching 17 minutes to go in this third period. Still a 1-goal lead for the Rattlers as Dean Ciderone dumps that puck into his own. Boylan gets it first, trying to work it back in front there, and it was kicked aside and turned away. Aiden Miller, native of Aurora, Ontario, weaving his way through the middle by one. Trying to get by his third man, Ciderone, but he stepped him up, and so that allows Richard Kuchma to get that puck back into the zone before it's whipped back to center to the possession of the Bradford Rattlers. It's Kuchma. We go D to D to Lutfiin. Stretch pass. He connects onto his man, Blake Anderson. Anderson from the zone. Rattlers are just playing keep away at the moment right now. For Rozkov, he got a shot on goal. Vladislav Morizuk, who will make the hold on and save. hasn't been that tested. Pastanet might have blanked Vladislav Morajczak. The only goals he let in came in the first period. Perfect second period until so far early, though not tested a whole lot. He's still perfect in this period. A lead chance off the stanchion, a 3-on-2 developing for West Nipissing. It's Brunet. Trying to lay that puck back in there. Picked off, however, by Oliver Malm. He has 2 points here tonight. From the backhand, he stutters away looking for real estate. Cross-seam pass, he found his man Blake Anderson. Anderson tried to get it back to Rosecop, but it peels on back, and the puck stays inside the zone. A turnaround hurry shot from the blue line. Came off the stick by Marcus Vargas, and an easy follow-up save made there by Morajczak. Again, Vladislav Morajczak played for the North York Renegades in the Southern Division last season. Of course, North York represented the Southern Division in the GMHL National Championship. Down low it comes there as the net has been kicked off, and that could have been a glorious chance to make it a 4-2 game, regain that two-goal lead. And if you've seen these games here in Bradford, you know the nets do look brand new. They're nice and white, fresh brand new nets. It's the same old story. They still come off their moorings just that easy. And oh my, how many playoff goals can you remember? I remember Yuri Skyler back in about 3 years ago in a playoff meeting against the Pirates. They were down a goal with about 2 minutes to go. He scored, but the net came off. Raptors ended up losing that game, and they ended up losing that series. So we can get some Rattler fans can get some PTSD when they see the net come off its moorings after there's been a beautiful chance at goal. And the man who almost had that fourth goal for the Rattlers before the net got kicked off, Melker Merlander, will be set off to the penalty box right now. A little bit of undisciplined play right now for the Bradford Rattlers. They don't take many penalties, but here and tonight, this is their fourth penalty. Long shot from the blue line was perhaps blocked there by Weisschick. Good clearing effort made by Richard Kuchma. Again, one of the more noticeable players in tonight's contest. In my opinion, he has been the Rattlers' best defender here tonight. Native of Vasas, Hungary, the 20-year-old, standing at 6'1", has a good reverse set. There, that was Blake Anderson colliding with Savignac. Savignac, 34 in the black, he is very deadly offensively, but he is not afraid to throw the body around. See a lot of similarity in Timo Meier's game. Anderson brought it into the zone, the whistle sounded, and I'm not too sure why. Oh, Blake Anderson doesn't have his mouth guard in. That's what it is. Referee caught it. Great eye by the official. Sucks that it goes against the Rattlers, but that is that's a terrific call. Terrific call. Good eye. See, we're giving the referees their props here tonight. I don't think I've ever done that in my 6 years commentating the Bradford Rattler games. Unfortunately, 15 minutes ago here in the third period, it is a 5-on-3 for the West Nipissing Lynx Rattlers, or pardon me, West Nipissing. Head coach Mo Mantha has called a 30-second timeout. Three power play set to start here. The first penalty has 1:18 to go, and of course this brand new penalty, 2 minutes exactly. So it's a long, long 5-on-3 power play. This is going to be the Lynx's best chance to get even here in tonight's contest, and they have all the weapons to use it here. Keep your eye on number 3, Matthias Weichai, who has the puck now on a breakaway. Weichai in, stopped by Balazs. Clearing attempt, not out. Second time effort. Does get out of the zone, and a chance here shorthanded, and it's Blake Keller, St. Cloud, Minnesota native. Stops on a dime as he has no teammates near him. That's to be expected. We only have 3 players out on the ice against the Lynx 5 as you see Laurent making his way past the Rattlers player there, Kochma. Laurent, 11 in black, back to Major, has some time in room. They'll elect to go back to Savaniak. Savaniak and Forge back down low for Weichai in the high slot. Picked out there. DeBook picks it up again. Cross seam pass, Weichai left it over for Major. Major turned on a dime. Jess Kuchma looking after his every move. Savaniak on the blue line. His shot was blocked in front there by Blake Keller. DeBook back to Savaniak. His shot stopped by Balazs. Big rebound and tearing that one loose and spinning it out is Blake Keller. And he is out of gas. And he finally gets a much-needed line change. Alvin Malm takes the spot forward-wise. One penalty has expired. Aiden Miller, or pardon me, Melker Melander, back onto the ice. 30 seconds to go in the one power play. It is currently 5-on-4 right now for the Lynx. They need one to tie. Weichai, that's the man you want to have the puck. He'll get it to Savaniak. Crossing pass. Laurent, a shot there kicked up by Balazs. He was deep in his cage there. Had the blocker side open. He snared that blocker out and denied the Lynx on a tying goal. Crossing pass. DeBook, 22 in black. Got over for Weichai. A drop pass to DeBook. Back in across the high slot. Dangling his way through. Savaniak shoots. Stopped by Balazs into the corner. Savaniak again from the line. Kicked out. And we're back to 5-on-5. Major swung it out across. Hasing him out was Weichai. His shot turned around, got the glass. Picking it up is Anderson. Checking away from Melker Merlander. Was Major there, and it's going to get called on and off sides. Now the action is starting to pick up quite a bit here in this third period. 12 minutes and 46 seconds to go here in the third. 3 for the Rattlers, 2 for the West Nipissing Lynx, and you just have a feeling this is going to be tight right down to the final horn. And don't be surprised if the word extra time comes up here tonight between these two teams. What an upset that would be for the Lynx. They come into Brasford, home opener, defending champions, everything like that, and they come out with a win? Yeah, that'll be pretty good. That's a perfect way to set the tone for your season. You knock off the defending cup champions? I think we'll be looking pretty good heading into the season. So let's see what West Nipissing can do here. Again, down a goal, 12 minutes and 29 seconds to go in the third. Turnaround shot rang off the iron on the turnaround bid from the hurry shot coming from Martin Borisov. Links back in, that's Laurent back in. Kicked away by Balazs. Defended away there by Borisov, 27 in white. Puck goes back down low, 4 bobbled it, but it came right in front of the crease area. Where Balazs had to quickly jump down and cover that puck up. Matthew Savaniak, Sturgeon Falls, Ontario native. The 19-year-old unable to put the face-off back. Rattlers have possession. The puck not out of the zone. It's Blake Barber keeping it in defensively. Barber engages offensively, but he's caught back down low. Ford Filion playing the part of defenseman there, allowing his man to cut right to the goal. It was Oliver and Mom looking for his second goal in the contest. Third point as a big hit there thrown on by Barber. Blake Anderson tried to reverse and hit back on his man. The whistle sounds and Anderson skating by Ford, taking a piece of him as he goes by. Definitely talking about the reverse hit back behind the play as we have an injured Bradford Rattler into the corner. That was Blake Keller, St. Cloud, Minnesota native, the 21-year-old. may have seemed like the head was the principal point of contact, but really tough to see from our vantage point. You can see in the camera right now on the bottom left of your screen. Well, he did. As we move the camera back to the action play. Yeah, the nearest corners near us in the camera at the bottom of your screen is our vantage point up here. Kind of tough the way the building is laid out. The seats and everything and people seating in them. Kind of hard to see these corners. So if I do lose possession or sight of the puck, I'm unable to call what's exactly going on in the corners. I apologize if the Lynx are buzzing in front of Balazs and a whack away in front. And here we go. Game 1 of 42 for the Bradford Rattlers, but it seems like Game 7 of the championship final. If this is going to be every game between the Lynx and Rattlers this season, sign me up for them in the playoffs again. And it looks like out of this scrum, it's the Lynx turn to sit in the penalty box. Tyler Brunet, native of Sturgeon Falls, Ontario, sits for 2 minutes. Blake Anderson off the tie-up. It's a clean win. Power play underway. Taking it back is Kuchma. Kuchma. Laid it on back for Anderson again. Back to Kuchma. Fakes the shot. Strand takes the shot. Who's got a bomb and used it here, but he just trickled it on wide. Lynx are able to clear that puck out of the zone. Again, Tyler Brunet. 2 minutes for cross check. Rattlers with a few power plays. They're losing their bank already. Anderson shields him to the corner where it's spear forked away. Alvarez Malm, 2 points here tonight to the blue line. It's Kuchma. Kuchma, his high shot deflected off the stick of Liam Thor, and it's out of play. The faceoff is staying inside the Lynx territory. 10:40 to go in the period. 1 minute, 20 seconds to go in the power play for the Bradford Rattlers here tonight. They lead by one. Alvarez Malm on the tie-up. The center zone draw, but it was pulled back. Alexander DeBook, good short-handed face-off win in his own end. The Rattlers trying to regain possession and stymie the Lynx back in their own end. Good pickup there by Anderson. He's got Laurent all over him, but he makes the play over to Strand. Strand, back down low, it comes to Blake Keller. Nice move by Keller. His shot turned away by Mazarek, and it's loose behind him. And he's able to locate that puck. Vladislav Mrazek, keeping the Lynx within one. If you're the Bradford Rattlers, that's exactly what you want here. You're still up by one, but you know another push by the West Nipissing Lynx are coming, most likely right after this power play, which expires in 57 seconds. Get whatever you can in this next 57 seconds on goal. Get some cycle going, get the flow, and try to get that two-goal lead back. It's going to be oh so important at this halfway moment of the third period. Get that power play goal. Should be looking all right as they nearly get one here. It's crashing in the net. Was Alvarez Malm. Play it from the backhand, Melker Merlander. Pinned up by Dorlay. Puck does not come out of the zone, but a nice second effort made by number 17 in black. Matthias Dorlay. I believe his brother is the one serving the penalty right now, Tyler. They both have the same last names. Easy for me to say that they are related, but you never know. I, in fact, do not know for sure. I'm just throwing that out. Rattlers back on possession. Right in front, and what a stop made by Vladislav Mrazek. Denying the chance there. And a glorious opportunity there for Anderson to make it 4-2. Again, Lynx up to the penalty. You're back to 5-on-5. Skating up now with Borisov. Borisov, 27 in white. Nice pass to Rotskov. Rotskov makes a nice pass in front there. Quick shot by Kochma. Rebound, it's loose. Mrazek is down, he sprawls loose, and so Drouin picks the puck up from behind his own cage. But it's not going to matter as another cross-checking penalty is coming to the West Nipissing Lynx. The Rattlers are going back on the power play. Caleb Boylan from Wawa, Ontario, 20-year-old, standing at 5'11". Will put his team down a man again. So after the first penalty was killed, the Lynx got to get their hard hats back on and head back to the penalty kill. And Rattlers have already cashed in on the power play here tonight. Strand, one-time shot, score! Richard Kuchma, who in my opinion, we've said it again, probably the best defender in this contest here tonight, the most standout player probably at all game for both teams. It's a power play goal again for the Rattlers. They lead 4-2. They reopen that two-goal lead. And like we were saying before the power play started, if you get one goal before the halfway mark of the period, you should be sitting pretty good, and that's exactly what the Rattlers do here. They get that insurance goal to increase their lead by two. Richard Kuchma scoring in his GMHL debut here with the Bradford Rattlers. Thomas Greve-Strand gets the assist, and how about that? Alvin Malm picking up another assist. It's a beautiful move there coming in front by Borisov, who draws another penalty. That's three straight penalties called by the West Nipissing Lynx in a span of 2 minutes, 2.5 minutes. Yeah, you could pull into factor that the Bradford Rattlers, after that latest power play goal by Kuchma, maybe suck the sails out of the West Nipissing Lynx here. But you're only still down by two. Don't get frustrated. Keep at the Rattlers. You get this penalty killed, you might be pretty good heading towards the latter goings of this contest. As you know, after this power play, the Lynx are going to come back. Even in years before, West Nipissing has always had this reputation of just never going away, just constantly being a thorn in the side of all teams, especially the Bradford Rattlers. Even though the Rattlers have been successful in most outings against the West Nipissing Lynx, the Lynx just always offer just so much trouble. As right in front there, another power play goal has been scored. Oliver Malm's second goal of tonight's contest. 4th point here tonight in the home opener. A power play goal. It's 5-2. A timeout has been called by the Bradford Rattlers. Or pardon me, Savignac is getting an unsportsmanlike conduct penalty, and he's barking off to the ref, and he's got himself kicked out of tonight's contest, and he's still giving it to the official. Savignac's night is done. And the wheels are starting to fall off. West Nipissing Lynx here tonight, down by 3 with 7 minutes and 41 seconds to go in the third period. And believe this, another penalty to the West Nipissing Lynx. Oliver Malm, you hear the official goal announcement here by JR. A 4-point game for Oliver Malm. And goals coming at 7:41 of this third period. Thank you so much, JR, for the announcement. Another power play for the Bradford Rattlers. Let's see what they can do here. Maybe it's an opportunity to play some guys that haven't necessarily seen a bunch of ice time here tonight. Maybe roll out the third, the fourth line, same thing defensively. Throw your second pair unit, your third unit on. You hear a spectator kind of heckle at the team. We're on a power play, set it up. Good step up there by Lookfullen. Again, he served a five-minute major penalty for cross-checking in tonight's contest. Got a reverse hit and another penalty upcoming to the Lynx. The Rattlers are going to have a 5-on-3 once Chris Nicholson gains possession. Rhodeskopf stopped on the dime, got it back down low. It's not touched up, however. So it gets to the play for Melker Moorlander. Pavel Rhodeskopf, one timer by Lookfullen, was kicked out with a purpose by the netminder Vladislav Morajsuk. And another penalty upcoming to the West Nipissing Lynx. It's going from bad to worse. Bad to worse, folks. See, there's so much stuff going on. Too many goals, too many penalties. I'm starting to lose my words. You know what? It's the first game of the year. I'll cut myself a little bit of slack. Just a little. Again, Nick Stillin here doing the play-by-play commentating for the Bradford Rattlers. So glad that I am back here for a sixth season. And it's good to see some familiar faces in the comment section. Of course, some familiar faces for the Bradford Rattlers here tonight. You just saw Blake Keller get another power play goal for the Bradford Rattlers. It is 6-2. They do it right in St. Cloud, Minnesota, or what? What a player. What a showing by Blake Keller here tonight. Number 9 for the Bradford Rattlers gets the second goal of tonight's contest. And that's been a story for a few players. Malm, and now Keller. Rattlers back in for more. A shot there. Big rebound just caromed on wide. Again, still a power play for the Rattlers. Lippfelin played it to the line. A good kickoff there by Rhodeskopf, who got sent to the ice there. And a breakaway chance here, but catching up to the puck is Aaron Stemper. Good speed by the Rattlers winger here, 14 and white. Stretch pass, it's Rhodeskopf. Rattlers have number here, potential 4-on-2 if they hurry. Wins the neat, goes behind. Another penalty upcoming to the Lynx, delayed call. One-timer there in front block. Rebound, a chance there, and shot after the whistle. Chitteroni takes exception to that. Clearly, it's frustration right now. And if you've played hockey in your life and you've been down a few goals and you know your team was there, the Lynx scored two straight unanswered goals in the second period, cut it within one, ran into a bit of penalty trouble here going as the game moves on. And that seemed to be the dagger in the heart of the Lynx. The Rattlers, very potent power play. And it's carried over from last year. Because last year in the regular season, the power play was 23%. 52 power play goals for last year. But for the Lynx, last season, their penalty kill, pretty good, 83%. Very solid and respectable penalty killing numbers. They surrendered 42 power play goals against. And unfortunately, the theme is catching up to the Lynx this season. I'm going to be honest, I've lost count how many power play goals the Rattlers have had. I'm sorry, I've lost count. Don't be surprised if Team White goes for more here. Aiden Miller to the blue line. Hellenius walks into one, stopped by Morajsuk. Comes to the line, but not out. Kept alive by Nugomanov. Got it across there to Vargas. Vargas trying to find Nugomanov, but it escapes away from him and he'll calmly play it across. Petri Hellenius, a native of Finland. Number 2 for the Rattlers, 21 years old, 6'5", believe it or not. Nugomanov has some time here, goes back down low. Sharp angle bid on the rising shot by Aiden Miller, rattled around from the glass and right to the netminder Balaji's play. Quick pass, it's Vargas, up the gut, intercepted. DeBuck, number 22 in black with the steal, one penalty is over. So we're back to 4-on-5. We'll be back to 5-on-5 in 45 seconds unless the Rattlers score within that time period, I should say. Strong connection of passes here. You can hear the sound of the puck slapping onto the blade from up here. can't have a soft pass in this league. Pass is always going to be crisp, and they got to be hard, and they got to be tape to tape, the old cliche. Both teams still battling for that puck. It gets chipped into the corner. William M. Bryles into the corner. Got it to the blue line, however. It's Strand. Has an assist here tonight on the power play. Long shot from the line. Kicked away by the netminder Mariza. Penalty is expired. We're back to 5-on-5. We are even. The first time in a while. Nathan Fisher starts back up on the back around. Dish was picked off by Strand. Ten and White makes his way into the length zone. It's kicked into the corner boards where it's played back along by Frank Ekholm, native of Sweden. Puck rolled in on goal. Kvalasov Mrazek, and so he made the play, and here come the West of the Sing Lynx. Alexander Dubuk, his pass, got foiled in front there by the Rattlers. Aaron Stemper back in, trying to make a lead pass, but Stemper still with possession. Stemper at backhand dish, nice play there on a touch combination feed. Aiden Miller, Borisov, kicked it away, and a nice diving defensive effort made by Lutfulin. Native of Kazan, Russia, the 18-year-old, using all of his 6'2 frame there to swap that puck away from Liam Thorne. Shot on deflection bid, and a save there by Vladislav Mariza. And again, another deflection save made by Mariza. We mentioned earlier in the contest, there's been a few deflected shots on goal to Mariza. Like we mentioned, deflections from the blue line, they normally go high to low. Rarely in this league you'll ever see it go low to high. So taking away the bottom part of the net on those redirections there, as soon as the puck comes in the line, that's just good goaltending awareness there by Vladislav Mariza. Shot there blocked, and the Lynx almost had numbers if they got up to that puck in time. The Rattlers' story of tonight's contest, just one step quicker over their opposition here tonight. Oh, look out there. Puck went right into the spectators' area. When you're watching the game, keep your eye on the puck because things like that can happen. I think it was a few years ago. It may have been my first year. I was doing the color with Joe Todd, if you remember back in the day, our old team, me and Joe Todd heading some games together. Did a few Bradford Bulls games here and there, but I believe it was when Al Megan came into town in my first year. Poor lady got hit with the puck right towards, just under where that puck landed, kind of just above the West Nipissing Lynx, or the Visitors team's penalty box area. Quite the scene, and hey, those things happen, gotta keep your eye on the puck. We have 2 minutes remaining in regulation time. Again, 6 for the Bradford Rattlers, 2 for the West Nipissing Lynx. Over in Malm with a 4-point night here in tonight's home opener. And during the player introduction, we said it again, he had the loudest ovation out of anyone. Caleb McLaughlin, 74 in black for the Lynx. Skated through center, chip in, and head off on a line change. Blocks. Steered it on ahead. Aiden Miller, Aurora, Ontario native, the 16-year-old, tripped up his band, but play will continue. Aaron Stemper, a nice pass, a shot saved by the breadbasket of Vladislav Mrazek, and he will hold on. Former North York Renegade thrown into a tough position here, got down early, 3-0 in the first period. Again, Lynx storming back to cut it within one. 3-2 was the closest the Lynx would ever get. Bradford Rattlers coming back with 3 unanswered of their own. I don't know how many again, but majority of them came on the man advantage. 5-on-4, 5-on-3, you name it. The Lynx have power play goal to boot as well. Perfect start for the Bradford Rattlers. We have jot down here. Haven't lost a home opener in their history. Believe that. Looks like the trend will continue. They are safe for another year, as it looks to be another decisive victory on home ice for Team White and Green. Again, credit to West Nipissing. They gave the Rattlers a very tough time in the second period. trying to think the Lynx played with a little bit more discipline. How different this contest could be right now. It could easily still be 3-2. You know, the 5-on-3 power play the Lynx had earlier in the second period. That was a beautiful chance for them to tie up the game and make it 3-3. But again, got to tip your hat to the penalty killing unit of head coach David Mooney's Bradford Rattlers. You see Strand using his speed here. Strand on a whirling effort, trying to whip it back across for his man Borisov. Couldn't quite connect on that play. Making that play at a 6-2 game, yeah, it's all right. We'll let that slide. It's a tie game in the last minute of the third period like we're in right now. Yeah, maybe not. 20 seconds remain in this third period. Laurent made a backhand pass out of the reach, or out of the reach rather, Nathan Fisher. Strand picks it up from the line. 3 seconds to go here in tonight's contest in the Bradford Rattlers. Will skate away with 2 points and a 6-2 victory over the West Nipissing Lynx. Oliver Balazs stopped all but 2 shots here tonight. A 6-2 victory over the West Nipissing Lynx and tonight's home opener here for the Bradford Rattlers. Great chance to look at all the new players Bradford Rattlers have for this season, and we're excited to give you all the information on these players and watch their progression and growth as the season goes on, and we hope that you guys can be along the ride with us. So for Nick Stella and the Bradford Rattlers organization, we'll bid you all a good hockey night for now. And we will see you next Sunday as the Bradford Rattlers take on the Knights of Meaford.